This is A.N. She's a 23-year-old woman from Georgia. A.N. is healthy by all means, but she can't figure out who's calling her when she answers her phone, and she can't tell when her favorite singer comes on the radio. She can tell people's faces apart, but if you asked her to imagine what a certain celebrity or, say, Kermit the Frog sounds like, she couldn't.
The story of A.N. is just one example of phonagnosia, a condition where people are unable to recognize or imagine familiar voices. It comes from phone, the ancient Greek word for voice, and agnosia, a loss of knowledge. So why can you tell voices apart?
Usually a few of our senses work together to identify people. For example, our vision and hearing team up to say, "Hey, that's Mario."
"Hey, that's Mario."
Researchers looked into how this works in a 2006 study where one group of people was exposed to pairs of voices and faces and the other group was exposed to pairs of voices and names. Then the researchers mixed everything up and asked one group to match the voices back to the faces and the other group to match the voices back to the names. The group that was exposed to pairs of voices and faces were faster at identifying the voices. They had more sensory information to work with. Still, people in both groups showed an increase in brain activity in specific areas.
They were all able to distinguish voices, and we do know that this is tied to our ability to decipher language. In another study, scientists found people with dyslexia had difficulty telling voices apart. They had an impaired ability to organize those little parts of language compared to those without dyslexia. But this effect was only in their native language. Once voices speaking foreign languages were introduced, everyone was bad at recognizing voices.
So the people in both of these studies could distinguish different voices, but recognizing voices, as in from those people you already know, is a separate ability. And there's lots of things that contribute to your ability to identify a voice, whether you know the person or not. Things like
accent, cadence,
intonation,
key,
phrasing,
pitch,
and stress patterns.
You use these characteristics of speech to build a picture of what someone's voice is like, just like you do with their facial characteristics. And your ability to recognize faces is actually linked to your ability to recognize voices.
The fusiform facial area is a specialized area of your brain that you use to recognize faces, and it's connected to part of your auditory cortex in three places. These three places all respond to human voices and are active when we attempt to identify voices. This response is researchers' best guess in the search to find the exact mechanism of voice recognition.
From an evolutionary perspective, identifying both voices and faces allows us to function as part of a social group.
Not everyone needs to comprehend language to recognize different human voices, though. When elephants were played recordings of voices speaking in two different languages, they reacted defensively to the language associated with locals who clashed with the elephants. Tamed horses can also distinguish and recognize human voices, as can dogs, cats, and even crows.
In the case of A.N., her phonagnosia is pretty rare. She couldn't store and retrieve those bundles of information that help us identify a voice. You know,
accent,
cadence,
intonation,
key,
phrasing,
pitch,
and stress patterns.
Our ability to recognize voices is one of those amazing things that your brain just does when it's on autopilot. If you take a moment to stop and think about it, it's pretty fly. And hear me out. If you can figure out which of my friends' voices were featured in this video, let me know down in the comments. Maybe it struck a vocal chord. I'll stop now.
And as always, thanks for watching.